The studio tour is officially called the Three Rivers Artists Biennial Studio Tour because it happens every other year. And it was started 22 years ago when I had an art gallery in town that I no longer run. And at the time, there weren't that many studio tours around the country, and it was kind of a new trend. And I knew all these wonderful artists up here in Three Rivers because this place for a long time has drawn creative people and artists to live here and work here. So my studio is the spare bedroom in this home where I live. And it's been evolving over the last 18 years. So it's had 9 times it's been on the studio tour as a studio space. And each time as I prepare for the studio tour, 6 months or more in advance, I start thinking about my studio and how I really would like it to be. And so I have moved everything around in this space this year. It's phenomenal what's happened for me by placing things in certain places, because as a collage artist, I collect a lot of stuff and it can be overwhelming and hard to deal with. And I have been having amazing breakthroughs with how I'm sorting and putting things so that I am actually seeing that the next years to come, I'm going to be making art in here in a way that I haven't made before. My art form is collage, which means I put things together to see what they can become. And I started doing this sort of officially about 20 something years ago, and I made these collages that I actually have a few of the originals here. I cut out things from magazines and I made these collages, these one-of-a-kind collages that I called It Could Be Art, and I put them into cards. And over the years, it's evolved into making all kinds of collages, bigger ones, smaller ones. And in the last couple of years, since the last studio tour, I've finally gotten brave enough to play with Photoshop, which was always really intimidating to me. And I'm starting to make collages using the computer. And I take my own photographs and I play with them on top of each other, and other parts of it make textures and change the colors. And so I don't really know exactly what I'm doing, and I don't have a distinct plan in mind of what the image should be. So it's just totally fun. So I was going to actually, my latest piece is up here on the computer. I thought I would actually hit the print button. So I take my prints and I print them on this really lovely paper that's archival, and I put them in frames sometimes or mat them, and I'm putting them on greeting cards. And just, and a couple of times I've actually taken them and put them directly on canvas. This painting here is part of a new series I'm working on called The Cosmic Egg, and it's also collage, but it's more like collage painting. And it has, it's made from a paper called Masa paper that you take and crumple up and get wet, and then you apply it to canvas, and then you add paint or ink or other kinds of things to it, and it becomes this kind of unusual textured painting that you probably can't see on video very well, but in person it has a totally different feel. And in this painting, some of the paint kind of leaked into the egg because I had wanted the egg to be really pristinely kind of off-white, and then this leaking came in, and those serendipitous wonderful mistakes is what actually makes the art. So I'm really looking forward to seeing what else is going to show up. The reason I keep doing it as an both as an organizer and as an actual artist on the tour is that it shows people how you can live with art making and how it can intersect with your daily life. And every artist on this tour has a different kind of place where they work, a different kind of place where they live, a certain kind of medium that they were particularly drawn to and spent time with to learn and become productive and creative. And so there's just all kinds of wonderful things to see here. And I've heard stories from people who have been on the studio tour that they've gone home and made, one fellow told me how he made a studio out of his garage because of this studio tour. So I never know how lives are going to be affected by this and what happens exponentially from the studio tour. And some magical things can happen when people should come together and start talking about art making. And I want to say something particularly about this studio tour 11 in Three Rivers. It was every studio tour, there's an artist I choose to be the featured artist, and we use a photograph of their work to be the primary mascot of the studio tour, to go on the postcards and the posters. And this year was to have been an artist named Nancy Johnham, who was an exceptional clay artist and sculptor in clay. And she unexpectedly died a little over a year ago, right before the art was due for me to make the first ad for this. And I had to come up suddenly with another featured artist. And so it ended up being me this time. And I made a collage, a digital collage for this. And what has happened for this particular tour is that Nancy's husband, who is a wonderful mosaic artist in his own right, is going to open the studio up as him with an artist, but he's also going to open up Nancy's part of the studio as it was when she left it. Many things in the studio have not been touched by her family, and her family are going to be there to answer questions and share a lot of her beautiful sculptures that are still there. They're not for sale because they're part of the family collection, but it'll be an opportunity to see how a person lived their life making art. So I hope people will come and see that and see all the other wonderful studios and artists on this studio tour in Three Rivers.